Cali 93.9, number one for reggaeton. Y más con una Cali exclusive, Cali Uchis. Bienvenida, Cali, Cali.
Hola, gracias por la invitación.
¿Cómo te va? ¿Cómo va tu día?
Todo bien.
Hey, te quiero dar las gracias por tomarte tu tiempo, primero que nada, para hablar con nosotros. And I want to congratulate you. We're going to do this in Spanglish, okay? I'm sure Spanglish is cool for you, right?
Perfect for me.
All right. So, bienvenida. Yo sé que te has dado la vuelta por aquí antes. I don't know if you recall. We're early believers de tu música.
Oh, thank you.
Te diste una vuelta aquí a while back with one of our girls. You did an interview out here at the station. So, we want to let you know that we're early believers in your music.
When was that?
It was a while, I would say like a year ago, fue con Caro Márquez, our morning show.
Oh, yeah, okay,
Jessica
cool.
Flores.
Oh, yeah, I love Jessica, yeah.
Yeah, really cool. Yeah. So, yeah, we're early believers in tu música, so here we go. So, Cali, man, tu canción Telepatía ha explotado alrededor del mundo. How do you feel right now? Has it sunk in, o todavía sientes como que andas en Telepatía?
Sabes que todavía me siento muy sorprendida, pero orgullosa, feliz.
Tu canción charting en 32 países, top charts. Mira, te sigo en el Instagram, veo todos tus logros. Haces tus posts, número uno aquí, número uno en México, número uno por acá. You're self-promoting yourself, and I love it. Sabes que eso fue una de las cosas que me llamó la atención cuando apenas salió la canción. Vi una de tus posts en tu página de Instagram y dije, I gotta check out this song. La escuché y me encantó. Dije, nosotros aquí no somos una estación que tocamos reggaetón y pop, trap, un poquito de tropical, un poquito de bachata. Our slogan goes reggaetón y más. So I said, this song is a little different, pero creo que sí va con nosotros. Y para que sepas, somos la primera estación aquí en Los Ángeles en tocar tu canción Telepatía. So I just want you to know that.
Amazing. Thank you so much. Honestly, LA has been so good to me. I really look at it like a home. It's been home to me for about 6 years now. And this is kind of where I got my start, my real start in music. And got a real shot at having a career. So I love it here. Thank you guys for supporting
me. No, claro. I did my homework antes de esta entrevista. Vi varias entrevistas tuyas y donde hablas mucho de Los Ángeles. Mencionas que muchos fans de aquí de Los Ángeles fueron los primeros en creer en ti. Y que varios artistas on the hip-hop side were also early believers in your music, like Snoop. Vi una entrevista donde hablas de Snoop, de que él fue uno de los primeros que te dio la oportunidad de trabajar on the English side, right?
Yes. Yeah, you know what? When I first dropped my first couple little, like, because I'm really, más que todo, no, pues yo no, nunca digo que soy una cantante, siempre digo soy un artista, porque más que todo, lo que, cuando yo empecé, yo quería grabar videos musicales y quería, a mí siempre me encantaba el hecho de mezclar música con el arte del cine. Entonces, cuando yo empecé a sacar cositas, eso es la única cosa que yo estaba tratando de hacer. No estaba como tratando de ser cantante ni nada de eso. Entonces, cuando a mí me empezaron a escribir desde Los Ángeles, desde Nueva York, yo estaba muy confundida, como que, ay, yo cómo llamé a la atención de tanta gente tan talentosa, solo haciendo cositas, pues, sin pensar mucho, like without really trying, I was just being myself, and it just organically got me a fan base and got me people who believed in me. So yes, a lot of those people that wanted to work with me were in LA, so I just immediately came out here.
Hay que hablar del cine. Tú dirigiste tu propio video de Telepatía. Felicidades on that.
Thank you.
You know what? Watching your video me recuerda a mí a mi país. Like big time. Yo nací en El Salvador y ver tu video y verte caminar en esas calles de Colombia, it made me feel at home. I'm like, I was definitely able to relate. And I love that you kept it simple.
Bueno, algo que a mí siempre me ha inspirado es siempre tener presente mi cultura, siempre tener presente el orgullo de Colombia, de Latinoamérica, porque para mí eso fue algo que me impactó mucho, no solo en mis ideas artísticas, pero como mujer, como niña. Cuando yo era niña, mis primeros años de educación fueron allá. Yo aprendí a leer, escribir y todo eso en español antes que inglés, y vivía allá en Colombia. Entonces, that's something that I always just wanted to make my people proud, and that was why I made my second album fully in Spanish, porque yo siempre tenía como ese deseo de compartir con toda mi gente de Latinoamérica. So I just wanted the video to be like, you know, very natural, like how the song came together, and also to just make people who live in Latin America to just be super proud of where they come from. Like, I already, and I've always directed my music videos, but one of my first music videos for my first project is called Riding Around, and we actually shot it in the street that I used to play in when I was little and that I grew up in. But since we already shot there, I wanted to shoot in a neighboring neighborhood that I also owned, and that was where we shot Felipe Antilla.
¿Cómo fue tu vida creciendo allá en Virginia? Me imagino que leía, te voy a hacer unas preguntas de la escuela, porque yo sé que estábamos hablando del cine y de tú dirigiendo tus propios videos. ¿Es verdad de que te salías de la clase para ir a practicar tu cine, tus fotos? ¿Es verdad?
Yeah, bueno.
No que queremos promover que nuestros niños no vayan a la escuela, right? Pero obviamente tú ya tenías, sí, más o menos la idea de lo que querías hacer.
Sí, bueno, primero que todo, educación.
Exacto.
Al mismo tiempo, creo que es muy importante siempre saber quién tú eres. Y yo, I always knew that I was an artist and that what I wanted to do with my life was going to be fully about art. I was going to dedicate my life to art, no matter if I was hungry, no matter if I didn't have money, no matter if I didn't have somewhere to live. I was like, I'm not going to have a job that I'm miserable doing just to make some money. I'm going to do what makes me happy with this. Entonces, I never took SATs. I never wanted to study anything, because I feel that art is something that you can't really be taught. That's just my personal opinion. I would personally never go to art school. So yeah, I just learned as much as I could, self-taught, and also just having access to like the different softwares and stuff that my school gave me access to, make me have the opportunity to like learn Final Cut Pro, learn how to use Premiere, edit photos, learn how to develop film, use darkrooms, use redroom. So it's like, that was what I was obsessed with. So I would just, you know, not go to my other classes sometimes and just be working on
it. ¿Qué traes ahí? Let me see that bear you got right there, if you don't mind. Okay. Tell us about that muñequito que traes ahí.
No, aquí, a mí me encanta the little kawaii stores. Es que en Los Ángeles hay muchas. Me encantan los creo que porque mi tía era fanática de Hello Kitty. Entonces, cuando yo era niña, she had everything. Hello Kitty. She had the big dolls, she had the little dolls. And so, it's childish, but it's
not. No, it's cool. Mira, tú y mi niña de 11 años se llevarían perfecto. She loves all that stuff. Siempre la ando llevando a las tiendas de eso. Stay a little girl forever.
Yeah, I love it.
So, felicidades en el Grammy. Quiero hablar de los Grammys porque en el 2018 tú estuviste nominada para R&B. No lo ganaste, pero fuiste nominada. Pero ahora recientemente, couple of weeks ago, 2021, fast forward to 2021, ganaste un Grammy on the dance category. Tú andas por todos los lados, por todos los géneros, right?
Sí. Bueno, básicamente yo siempre, like how I said, I never saw myself like a cantante. I see myself always like a just artista. Entonces, para mí, mi música no pertenece a ningún género, y así, así me gusta, porque creo que cuando una persona just limits themselves to like one space, don't get to like experiment as much, and that's what's fun for me about making music, is to be able to really play with all of the possibilities. So
Right.
yeah, and also with being growing up in two different countries, like growing up in the United States and Colombia, I feel like I always had so many different influences musically. So yeah.
Al rato sales con una cumbia colombiana, maybe.
Oh, uno nunca sabe.
Just messing with you. So, hay que hablar de la música. So, growing up, en la escuela, you're trying to become an artist. ¿Cuáles fueron los top three que te influyeron a ti? And you said, you know what? I like what that artist is doing. Or I would love to do something similar to what that artist is doing. Top three.
¿Sabes qué? A mí siempre me preguntan eso y yo nunca, I never know what to say, because I never really had like, I don't feel that artists should have someone that they want to like base their career off of that person, or base their artistry off of that person. But that's just because I'm of the mind that like everybody is unique and everybody should do their own thing. It's one thing to get like, yo soy una mezcla de todas las cosas que me inspiran, pero eso tiene que ver no solo con artistas, pero con cultura, con arte, con pues no solo una cosa específicamente. Entonces es muy difícil. Tengo artistas que I definitely admire. I admire Shakira for her social work. As a Colombian girl myself, growing up, I definitely always looked up to her and her music, and always loved how she like uplifted our people, uplifted our country. I always admire Selena because, you know, as a obviamente como una mujer que era latina, pero también era de los Estados Unidos, y siempre, siempre tenía esa cosa presente como de querer usar su idioma, querer cantar en español y en inglés, pues eso me identifico. Y obviamente, she's an icon
Right.
for everybody. So, of course, I feel like as a Colombian American, just as like a girl who growing up, like I always had women, pop cultural icons like that, like Selena, Shakira.
¿Quisieras una collab con Shakira? Si Shakira te levantara el teléfono y te dijera, "Hey girl, your song is popping. I'm watching you." Quiero hacer una canción contigo. ¿Qué le dices a Shakira ahorita?
Shakira can get whatever she wants from me. I'll just whatever
Ahí
she
está. We're gonna make it happen. We're gonna make it happen. Maybe on the remix.
wants.
Telepatía remix featuring Shakira. Imagine that. Woo! I'm just saying. I'm just saying. I'm no pressure. No pressure. I'm just saying. Hay que hablar de telepatía. So. ¿A quién le estás cantando Telepatía? Is there like, you know, were you picturing somebody in your head when you were singing it? Is there somebody special para Cali Uchis that inspired you to make that song?
Es que la verdad es que no, no había, ah, no, qué mentira, si había alguien.
Sounds like we're gonna get something juicy. Dámelo,
Se me
dámelo.
olvidó. Es que bueno, todos creen que yo escribí esa canción durante la pandemia, pero yo la escribí hace un rato, fue antes de la pandemia. Entonces, sí, había alguien. Pero la cosa es que no podemos hablar de esto.
Ah, come on. Just a little hint.
Bueno, puedo decir que I was definitely talking to somebody who didn't live in the same state as me.
Somebody that's in LA. Did you say LA?
No,
Oh, okay.
I don't talk about, I don't talk to people in LA, not that much.
Don't
Well, I
worry,
feel
I'm not
like
gonna put you in the spot. I'll leave you alone on that one. Okay.
es que toda la gente acá ya se conocen. Entonces, you try to talk to somebody from LA and that person already talks to your best friend. It's like,
Hardcore fans are gonna be putting puzzles together como que si es una película de los Avengers.
yeah, so I like to talk to people that don't live where I live, because The town is too small.
Right. So I'll make it a little easier. Kali Uchis single. Fellas want to know. I'm just saying.
Oh, am I single?
Yes.
Am I single? I'm not single.
Ooh. That's where telepatía comes from.
Yes.
It's okay. Ahí te dejo ahí. Let's switch it over. Working with Tiny con la canción Telepatía, cuando escuchaste ese beat, ¿qué sentiste? Yo sé que eres, por lo que veo, eres una persona muy espiritual, right? ¿Qué pensaste en ese momento cuando escuchaste la beat y dijiste, esta canción se va a llamar Telepatía or you know, along those lines?
Sí, bueno, yo ya tuve una canción que yo estaba escribiendo, pero era en inglés, que se llamaba Telepathy, y era como, pues, era algo similar, pero totalmente diferente. Digamos que era similar el concepto. Yo ya tenía como ese concepto en mi mente, pero nunca me ha llegado la oportunidad de hacerlo en español. Entonces yo estaba en Miami, estaba haciendo un montón de canciones ese día, y muchas veces cuando llego a somewhere new, I just get inspired to be in a new place. So I was very inspired that I had just got to Miami. I was just cutting. And cuando empezamos a escuchar esa pista, me sentí como muy, bueno, como que yo ya conozco este sonido. Para mí era como algo muy similar a After the Storm, que fue como la canción más exitosa de mi primer disco. Entonces, para mí, ese sonido es muy, like, it's very natural for me.
Right.
It's nothing forced about it for me. I know how to ride those type of beats very easily. So, me sentí en casa. Me sentí como que, bueno, ya sé lo que necesito hacer. Y ya, entonces, it really came out very, very fluid. And I feel like that's the most important songs. Just like, I kept mentioning that I had written that Kitchen Out a song for like 30 minutes. Not to brag.
It took you 30 minutes to do Telepatía?
Telepatía, I think, was less time than that.
Wow.
And I don't say it to brag. I only say it to let other artists know that sometimes what comes the easiest and most naturally and what's most fluid, a lot of times is the best. Because there's definitely been times where I tried to make the song work or I tried to put things together, and it just doesn't flow the way that it needs to.
It doesn't add up, right?
Yeah. When things just come to you naturally, a lot of times that comes from the most purest place that it needs to come from. It comes from your soul. And that's the type of music that can actually connect with people long term. Because when I look at the songs that I have that came like that, it was like off my first EP, era una canción que se llama Loner. I did all of that in one take, and it just literally happened as soon as I heard the beat. After the Storm, same thing. I did all that in Canada with Bad Bad Not Good. They started playing music, and I just started singing, and that was the song.
One take.
Yes. And so those are the songs that ended up being like those songs off of my album, and they're the ones that just happened the most naturally. So it's, for me at least, it's music from the soul that I feel like is timeless. And that's why a song like Telepatía, I wrote it so long ago. And then, pues, da la casualidad de que estamos, nos metimos en un pandemia, y pues, esa canción se puso more relevant than it probably would have been.
¿Esperaste que Telepatía explotara de la manera que explotó? Just joking around, una de mis coworkers aquí me dice, hey, pregúntale por favor a Kali Uchis, ¿cuál es el secreto to become famous on TikTok? Porque yo creo que TikTok tuvo mucho que ver con el éxito de la canción, ¿sí o no?
Bueno, digamos que, pues, hay personas que dicen como sí, que mucho del éxito llegó desde TikTok, pero al final del día yo veo muchas canciones en TikTok que son exitosas en TikTok, pero eso tiene nada que ver que la gente van a ir a comprar la canción o van a ir a escuchar la canción más después de eso. Entonces, uno nunca sabe. You could have a song that blows up on TikTok, but that doesn't mean people are going to actually keep listening to the music.
Right.
Know? this one little part of a song. So at the end of the day, it has to be a good song for people to go and be for people to go and be buying it and streaming it the way they are acting. That is great exposure. TikTok gave the song great exposure because, like you said, how you noticed that I self promote a lot. I do that because cuando yo empecé, solita, sin, without any money, without any, I wasn't the type of artist that had like some type of marketing team around me or some type of.
You're a one girl team.
I'm a self-developed artist. Like, I developed myself and I grew in public from day one, literally. And so for me, it's like, I'm used to self-promoting because if I don't promote me, who else is going to do it?
Right. Who's going to do it better than you, right? So dime, aparte de Shakira, obviamente ya hablamos de Shakira, de que you looked up to her growing up. Si tuvieras la, me imagino ahorita con el éxito de la canción de Telepatía, everybody's knocking on the door, right? Hey girl, what's up? Pero si tú pudieras escoger a alguien, let's just say you had the chance to pick somebody, ya mencionamos a Shakira, si tuvieras que escoger algún artista on the Latin side, que pudieras hacer una canción ahorita que digas, man, quisiera poder hacer una canción con este artista, ¿hay alguna en mente?
¿Sabes qué? En esta etapa de mi carrera, más que todo me estoy enfocando como en mis cositas, porque yo ya tengo muchas colaboraciones, y eso es muy lindo. Puede ser que en el futuro voy a hacer más, pero más que todo estoy pensando, porque lo que a mí, like, what I'm most proud of is that this song, I stood on my own, and like, as a female Latin artist, to have a song that's getting as far with no feature is amazing. So it's like, I'm not really focused on collaborations right now at all.
Okay. Fair to say. Ahora hay que hablarle a las niñas, all the girls that are looking up to you right now, y que dicen, man, I wanna start like she did, you know. Ella hizo todo sola, hiciste tu mixtape, lo pusiste, you got your own buzz going. If you had to summarize it in less than, you know, a minute, ¿qué sería el mejor consejo que le dieras a estas niñas that are looking up to you right now at this very moment?
Bueno, mi consejo sería que your biggest strength is what makes you unique. Ser única es la más importante cosa, porque sí, hay mucha competencia, pues hay muchas personas que creen que las mujeres, pues todos estamos en competencia, pero verdaderamente no es así. Lo que no entienden los demás es que puede ser muchas mujeres exitosas y talentosas. Eso tiene nada que ver con, pues una no tiene nada que ver con la otra. Entonces, don't worry about what another girl is doing. Don't worry about how you're going to look. Don't worry about what other people are doing at all. Porque para mí, eso fue la cosa que yo siempre he tenido presente. Es, I'm making my own name. I'm making my own lane, and there could be a million people more beautiful than me, who could sing better than me, who have more money. I didn't have any money when I started. I didn't have any team when I started. And there's people who have huge teams and so much money backing them, and their first music videos are huge. And that, you know, it's not, that's why I did Telepatía the way that I did, like just normal, sencillo, porque that's where I come from, you know, doing everything guerrilla style, doing everything on my own. And that's what helps set you apart, because no matter how much money or assistance somebody else has, they'll never be you. So don't ever limit yourself because you think that you don't have money or you don't have resources. Porque eso, sí, eso es un reto muy grande, pues, the lack of resources for a lot of artists, because, you know, a lot of money just goes into, like, cool, certain type of artists, you know?
Hey, muchas gracias por ese consejo que le diste a las ladies. Me están diciendo ahí que I got a couple minutes left, so I want to get this one through since we're on the ladies' side. Para las ladies, yo sé que tú eres muy fashionable. Para las ladies que están mirando ahorita, ¿qué son 3 or 4 things que siempre traes tú en tu cartera that you will not leave home?
Definitely my sunglasses. Caviar. porque básicamente no tienes que tener maquillaje, pero si tienes labial, pues todo bien. Lip
Vital
gloss
one, ¿huh?
and nail filer, porque a
Oh.
mí pues me parece horrible cuando, ay no, es que eso that gives me nightmares, having a cracked
Ahí está. I just had to ask a couple of things, you know, that I think ladies would want to know about. Muchos éxitos. Cuando vengas aquí a Los Ángeles y todo esto de la pandemia se calme, we want you here live, girl. Oh,
I live here.
you okay? Okay, is that the pad here in LA?
Let's go. Yes, I'm here.
Okay, pues ahí está, mucho más fácil. Hay que dejar que todo el mundo se ponga la inyección primero y después te das la vuelta por aquí. ¿Qué te parece?
Yes, that makes a
I'll
big
work it
deal.
out with Lauren. Muchísimas gracias. One more time, okay?
You guys, thank you so much.
Have a good one.
You too.
Bye bye.
Bye-bye.